to take Uncle Dida to Jannah alone. Wallah, I have met and heard the testimony of hundreds and thousands of youngsters who have come to the true part of Islam, Muslims. True part means for the only namesake Muslims. Only that alone, our morale is boosted. That alone is sufficient, I believe, to take Uncle Dida to Jannah. I know Uncle Dida personally has reverted, people say convert, 10,000 Christians to Islam personally, 10,000, that's the record of IPCI. And indirectly, several thousands. I tell these people, let's find there are different strategies of doing the job. You tell that Uncle Dida, the Christians, they run away from Islam. I am witness that now when I travel in different parts of the world, not only in India, there are hundreds who I have met personally who have only accepted Dida, only they accepted Islam only because of Uncle Dida. And just last month I was in a conference, International Dawah Conference in Singapore, and there's a very famous writer, a lady who's a European, by the name of Rukaya Waris. Many of you all may have read her books. She has written about 30 books on Islam. She met me. As I was mentioning, Sister Rukaya Waris, she told me in the Dawah conference, and she was one of the speakers, and she said that one of the major factors for her to accept Islam is Sheikh Ahmed Dida. I'm sure the uncle doesn't know who this lady is, because she became a famous writer recently. I doubt that the uncle read any of her books. There may be thousands such Christians, or tens of thousands of Christians, who have accepted Islam only because of the cassettes of Sheikh Dida. So it's totally nonsense to say that all the Christians will run away. I do agree that there may be some Christians who may be put off because of different styles and strategies of Dawah. And what Uncle did at that time of his life was the best, I think. The style that was used. We Muslims want the receiving end. All of them receiving it. Whether it be in States, whether it be UK, whether it be South Africa, any part of the world, we want receiving it. Now the strategy has changed. Now when I go to States, because of Uncle Dida's lecture, the top Christian missionaries, those are top on the internet actually, they tell me, Brother Zakir, we agree that the Bible is not the word of God. Because when they have to have a debate, they will lose. Their strategy has changed. But they ask the next question. What about the Quran? You can't say our Quran has wrote mistakes. So because of Uncle's effort, Alhamdulillah, we Muslims are proud to call ourselves Muslims. I do agree, depending upon the place in which you are living, the styles and strategies of Dawah may differ. But what Uncle is doing, Alhamdulillah, is one of the best ways out. At that time it was the best, and now depends. For example, people ask me, the cassette of Uncle's Hinduism to Islam, it did create a controversy. Very frankly, they ask me that, will you show this cassette in Bombay? And I'm very frank. Let's see, Bombay is a different situation. Bombay is one of the places where it is the most difficult to Dawah. There, because we have the Hindus ruling us, there I would say fine, I would not use that strategy. But that doesn't mean that strategy will not work in any other part of the world. I don't agree with that. Here, you don't have to be scared of anyone. The strategies differ depending upon how you're doing and to whom you're doing now. It differs. Wallah. Fine. I do agree. The only cassette of Ahmed Didat, which I have not kept in the library, we have one of the largest collections of Sheikh Didat in the world for public, more than even IPCI, previously or today. We have 250 cassettes of Uncle for public. Ours is the largest collection in the world. We have about 4,500 video cassettes for free hire. 250 of only of Uncle Ahmed Didat. That's the strategy required there. But that doesn't mean we cannot use that strategy in any other part of the world. I'm aware that there are Muslim organizations who got together and who condemned Uncle, which are very hurt. And I've seen some of the cassettes which believers have sent me. The strategies differ. The style of doing dawah differs in different parts. That's Uncle's style. He's a specialist in one style, which yet a da'i should know. I know many da'is who are more knowledgeable than Uncle Didat. They are very soft. But wallah, how many people's life have they changed? Since I keep on traveling, I have not come across any individual who says that that da'i has changed my life. Surely these da'i may have changed some people's life, but not to the amount what Sheikh Didat's cassettes and lectures have done. Hundreds of thousands in different parts of the world. So you should realize that Uncle is an expert in the field, and only if you're in his shoes and in the field will you realize the way he does the job. There are many paper da'is we have today. Paper da'is means theoretical da'is. We keep on talking about dawah. But only if you're in the field, on the stage, meeting different types of people, will you realize how you dawah. Fine. If you feel that's not the best methodology, Uncle always told the people. If you feel my style is wrong, you're most welcome to adopt any style. But get results. Don't just talk. Those who say that Didat's style is wrong, are they in the field of dawah? Wallah, anyone who's actually in the field of dawah will never say that. Like those people in the riots in Bombay who objected when the Hindus said that azan should not be given on the microphones. The people who objected maximum were those people who didn't come for salah to the mosque. And I realize that whatever Uncle Ahmed Didat is today, if anyone receives appreciation, I believe it's his wife, Auntie Didat. That's the reason when Uncle came to Bombay, wallah, we didn't present him with any plate. But when Auntie came in 1988-89, we presented a plate to Auntie in appreciation for her work. And Uncle Didat said that he was very happy. It is the first time that Auntie received an appreciation plate, and I know what it is. The support of the family is very important. For a da'i to be successful, the support of the family is very important. And even today, if the support of Auntie, that is yet, alhamdulillah, keeping the spirit in Uncle, though whatever condition he is in today, yet to whatever level da'wah he can do, he's yet doing alhamdulillah. And his son, his daughter-in-law, all of them, the family supported him. Because I know today, if it had not have been the person who is responsible for me to be in the field of da'wah, after Uncle Ahmed Didat, it is my family support. If it had not have been for the support of my mother, I would not have been a full-time da'i. The support of my father, the support of my brother, of my sister. Yet people come and tell me that your brother Dr. Muhammad Naik, doesn't he give lectures? And wallah, he's a better speaker than me. He used to speak in college. He was the leader of the union. They tell me,